We would love to say there's no more racism, but it wouldn't be true. Some people may do it on purpose, but most people don't even realize they're being racist. Nowadays, racism is not as bold and as aggressive as it was, but this doesn't mean we should ignore it. As the legendary musician and activist Bob Marley said, until the philosophy which holds one race superior and another inferior is finally and permanently discredited and abandoned, I will not rest. Until there's no longer first-class and second-class citizens of any nation, until the color of a man's skin is of no more significant than the color of his eyes, I will not rest. That until the basic human rights are equally guaranteed to all without regard to race, I will not rest. So until racism in our community is reduced, we will not rest. We're a group of African Canadian youths who live in Bully and Kipsling area, and we are trying to reduce racism and grow an inclusive and equal community by sharing our stories. This movie takes you on a journey of our experiences in the Northeast neighborhood. We show what really happens from our perspectives and hope to encourage people to look for the other side, the side that makes all humans equal.
Because people ask me for weed, like for drugs, because I'm black. Like most of the time they don't ask like white people or different colors, they only just come ask us black people for drugs, special weed and stuff.
People think just because we're black or people with dark skin, you know, people think like you do bad stuff, like not really involved in anything. All you have to do is just drink and do drugs and stuff. That's why people ask us for drugs, and then most of us aren't even like that. Most of us just want to like play sports and hang out with friends. So that's where we get offended.
Just because I'm black, I'm good at any sport. They think I don't actually train for the sport. They think I'm just natural built like that. Like I'm good at any sport.
They don't believe you work hard. Me and Medis, they think we're good because we're black. They think we're good teams. That's what it's to be in track and field.
Run fast, jump higher, because we can do tall.
What makes us uncomfortable is that when we're walking down the hallway, there's always people staring at us. Like, we don't feel comfortable like that.
And that's true. At our school, there's the group of Asian, the white group, and the Spanish group. And there's only a few of us Africans. It doesn't matter where you come from or what type of skin color you have. We're all the same. So why make us feel so, like
the outsiders?
Well, me and a couple of my group friends will be playing basketball in the park, and like after when we're done, we'll come back home. Like it's not even that dark, and then all of a sudden, the police just come out of nowhere and stop us for no reason and try to check us if we have any drugs or something illegal on us. So it got really annoying. So we decided to call Asian Marcel, and he came and gave us some tips about racial profiling. How we can avoid it or react to it when people ritual profiling us.
You also talk us as a police station and show us like a different of criminal profiling and racial profiling. And also you took us like around of the police station. You showed us like the jail, like the cars, like how people just come in, they check them like first if they have like anything them.
I've been playing soccer since when I was here, and after I came to Canada, when I went to the park and I was trying to play soccer with the people around there, and I don't know why they did that.
We really get offended. We think it's because we're from a different race.
Be the same. That's just the way it is. Oh. want to be, only way I've been practicing my whole life to live my life is to be responsible for what I do. I don't know how to be responsible.